Real world self defense combines several different styles. One of them is Muay Thai. And like I said, some of the things. Well, just in the demonstration, you guys don't have to worry about the Olympics yet. So, Muay Thai combines very efficient strikes with body parts that don't require a whole lot of training, like elbows, knees. This, which can take years to learn, very effective. You can punch in people all the time. You don't have to know quite what you're doing. You might hurt your wrist. Additionally, we teach Gracie Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. It's mostly grappling. And so, since 90% of all real fights go to the ground within just a few seconds, it's important to make that your element. So let's say you get on top, I'm bigger, I wanna hurt her. What she's doing here, she's locking her legs around me, which even though she's on the ground, puts her in the dominant position. She can really control my momentum. Pull me back when I try to hit her, pull me in to hit me. If I try to choke her, go ahead, armbar. She just gets me up her really quickly. Break my arm or just make me more calm so I'm not attacking her anymore. Thank you. And finally, we teach part of Israeli Krav Maga, which is basically a survival by aggression, by explosive movement. So people that'll be attacking you, they think they can win if they're attacking you. They're going to be bigger, they're going to be stronger than maybe many opponents. So it is inherent to the style for you to be as swift as possible, but it doesn't require you to be stronger. So, for instance, I have her from behind like so. This is a bad situation for anybody, but I'm also bigger, potentially stronger than her. Without even needing to really fight me, she can turn the situation to her advantage very quickly just by use of leverage.